Samsung's Galaxy Buds 3 are the latest wireless earbuds from the South Korean manufacturer, and this time around, Samsung has abandoned the teardrop-shaped design in favor of the long stems popularized by Apple's AirPods. These do look stylish, but what concerns me is that Samsung may have also copied the 0 out of 10 repairability score that we've seen on Apple's AirPods. It was only 4 years ago that we gave the Galaxy Buds Live a repairability score of 8 out of 10, so an AirPods-like design would represent a significant regression for Samsung. Now, each of these earbuds has a tiny lithium-ion cell inside it, which means they'll wear out over time. Depending on how you use your earbuds, they could wear out as soon as a year or two after you buy them. So unless you want to spend $180 every couple of years, you'll want to be able to replace the batteries inside these things. The folks over at Phone Repair Guru expertly demoed how you might disassemble the Buds 3 Pro using a special jig and a rework station. We don't have the jig that Phone Repair Guru used, but we do have the Buds 3 on our teardown table. And it's worth mentioning that some specialized repair shops have the ability to repair a portion of these AirPods-like buds. But most repair shops and most consumers do not have the tools or the skills necessary to perform a repair like this. The fact that I need to use a vise is a poor start for our repairability assessment and foreshadows what's to come. Like the Apple AirPods, the battery sits behind the driver and everything is glued in place with adhesive. I can eventually create an opening for my pick by evenly applying heat around the seam and prying up with the sharp edge of a knife. The pick is a safer tool to use when slicing away the remaining adhesive, this way we're sure not to cut any of the delicate ribbon cables underneath. And already we're seeing a big difference between the Buds 3 Pro Phone Repair Guru Teardown and the Buds 3 on our table. The driver assembly sits on one side, and the battery remains firmly glued in on the other. It takes a bit of alcohol and a fair amount of heat, but I'm eventually able to lift the battery out to reveal two solder points connecting the battery to the stem of the buds. Unlike the Buds 3 Pro's press connector that pops away, the Buds 3 requires some delicate soldering to disconnect the battery. Replacing the glue that gives the Buds 3 their IP57 rating is going to be near impossible. The rest of the Buds 3 can be seen traveling down the stem of the bud. But once we pop the bottom cap off, it becomes clear that getting anything out of the stem is going to be close to impossible. The entire stem is packed with glue, and even using a ton of heat only allows me to chip away at it. What a nightmare. The buds were a bit of a disaster, but I'm still hopeful that the case may have some redeeming qualities. While the overall structure of these cases are similar between brands, each manufacturer has taken a different approach to their design. What they share in common is the lithium polymer battery inside them that, just like the buds, degrades over time and needs to be replaced. Let's see where the Buds 3 case lands as far as repairability is concerned. Like Sony's XM5s, it's good to see that the case is only held in by clips. That allows for the innards to slide out without causing any damage to any other component. A few screws hold the two sections of the plastic housing together, and once those are out, I'm able to lift out the bracket. Removing two more screws and then disconnecting a cable allows the battery, charging cable, and main board to slide right out. Under the charging coil, we find the battery, which is adhered to the case, but its cable seems to connect to the other side. The main board is held in place by one screw, but also soldered to the wireless charging coil on the other side. Lifting the board up reveals that the board and battery are connected using a couple of surface mount copper springs. Being able to replace this 2 watt hour battery without too much hassle is a major repairability win. Too bad we didn't have more positive news about the buds themselves. While there are specialized tools out there that allow for a non-destructive approach to disassembling these pods, it's still not a guaranteed repair. From difficult to replace adhesives to soldered battery connections, there are a number of things that make the reassembly of the Buds 3 extremely repair hostile. But moreover, it's entirely unreasonable to expect the average person to keep a jig, a rework station, and all the other tools that the Buds 3 needs for a simple battery replacement in what is, at the end of the day, consumer-grade electronics. And while the Buds 3 case follows some of the best repairability examples on the market, it's not enough to redeem the product as a whole. If you're looking for repairable earbuds, take a look at the Fairphone Fairbuds, which received a perfect 10 out of 10 for repairability, and also stand out as an example of what is achievable in repairable design. As for the Galaxy Buds 3, we're giving them a score of 2 out of 10 on our repairability scale.